What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to install and use the Trash Cans mod in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. There are plenty of mods and mod packs that are made for the spectacle. Packs like those are made to be played for hours on end and often leave you wanting more. But there are also things called quality of life mods, which deserve just as much attention. The one we're going over today is no exception. Introducing the Trash Cans mod. Instead of excess items taking up your inventory or manually throwing them into a lava pit, now you can have trash cans right outside your own base. Head to the Trash Cans CurseForge page and press the Files option near the top, and next click View All to the right-hand side, and then you can select your game version from the menu in the top right corner. Find and select the mod version that you want, and then click Download, and then save this file to a safe location for later, and do the exact same process for the Core Lib Dependency mod that will be linked down below. Before we get started with the install, first, you're going to want to make sure that Forge is installed, which we do have a guide to if you need to know how to do that. Once that's done, open your Minecraft launcher and head towards the installations area. Find that Forge profile and then click the folder icon. And in the new window, you can find and enter the mods directory. Drag and drop the mod files into this area, and then you can return to your Forge profile and push play. Head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server. Click FTP file access near the top left, log in, and then find the mods folder. And in the top left, press upload and drag the files into the right side. Once these are 100% uploaded, use your server name at the top to return to the main panel and then restart the server. You're not going to see any noticeable differences when you first enter the world, since the only thing this mod is adding is 4 different blocks. These are, of course, all trash cans, but they all have their own unique aspects. They work by transporting materials into the void, completely removing them from your game. That being said, they also have a filtering system to make sure certain items don't disappear. Let's go over all 4 and what they do. By far the most popular one that most players will be using is the item trash can, since this allows you to throw away almost any material. This includes materials that might come from other mods that you might have on the server. As for its crafting recipe, you're going to need cobblestone, stone, and 1 chest. Next is the fluid trash can, which, you guessed it, only allows fluids. This is usually in the form of water or lava buckets, but other materials from different mods can also work. It's definitely not the most handy, but if you find yourself needing it, you can make it with cobblestone, stone, and a bucket. Even less popular than the last one is the energy trash can, allowing you to drain energized weapons, tools, and other items. This is not going to be very useful to you if you don't have other mods on your server, but if you have something like mechanism, then it actually could come in handy. You can craft this one with cobblestone, stone, and redstone dust. And finally, the one that combines them all, the ultimate trash can. This means players can delete items, liquids, and energy in their world. It's absolutely not necessary, especially if you don't have much use for the energy and fluid cans, but it's nice to have just in case you do end up having materials that you would like to throw away. To make this, you're going to need one of each of the 3 cans before, so if you have the materials, it doesn't hurt to add this to your world. If you aren't able to join the server, then make sure both the trash can mod and the dependency is installed on both the server and the client. You're also going to want to check to make sure the version you're running matches the version of your server. If you can't use one of the trash cans, then make sure you're putting the correct items into the right ones. For example, you can't put a water bucket in an item can, but you can put it in the ultimate. There's also a chance you're trying to get rid of a modded item that just isn't supported. While some do work with the mod, not all of them do, so it's going to take some trial and error to see what works. As you can see, the install process isn't too hard, and the mod is definitely worth its weight. Adding this mod to a server with your friends will definitely make your game run more smoothly, and you'll have a lot less clutter in your inventory. That's it for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.